Hi lads, so we're going on to the next section of trigonometry today, okay? So I just want to first introduce it by looking at these right angle triangles and naming the different sides, okay? You know from Pythagoras' theorem that the longest side of any right angle triangle is directly across from the right angle, and that's called the hypotenuse. Okay, so always mark the hypotenuse first. It's across from the right angle triangle. So it's across from the right angle, that's the longest side there, okay? The other two sides have special names as well. So if you have the angle marked here, across from it is the opposite side. Okay, so where is the opposite side here? It's directly across from the angle marked. It's the opposite side, okay? And the one that's left then is called adjacent. So adjacent means next to. And over here, adjacent, it's the last one that's left. Okay, so you've naming your three sides. Hypotenuse first is across from the right angle. Opposite across from the angle marked. And then adjacent is the last one left. Okay, why are these important? Because in when solving right angle triangles, we can use the hypotenuse, opposite and adjacent to help us find the measures of the angles, okay? Pythagoras' theorem, if we use that if we have any two sides and we're looking for a third, okay? So just to look at these ones here, okay, could you label the sides hypotenuse, opposite and adjacent? Let's start with this triangle. Where is the hypotenuse? It is the longest side there, okay? It's the longest side. How do I find it? It's across from the right angle. So I'm just going to say HYP for short. Next up is the opposite. Well, it's opposite the angle marked, so it's OPP for opposite. And adjacent is the last one left, ADJ for adjacent. On to the next one. What's the longest side across from the right angle is the hypotenuse. Across from the angle marked is the opposite. And the last one then is the adjacent. Next up, we have the longest side is this one, the hypotenuse, because it's across from the right angle. The opposite side is across from this one. And adjacent is the last one left. Okay, so just get used to marking those. So you draw it, label it, and then we'll write sohcahtoa afterwards. Okay, what was that word I just said? Well, I'll show you now, okay? So as you can see here, we have three. It's the sine, the cosine, and the tangent. But you're going to shorten them to sin, cos, and tan. The only place you've possibly seen these before would be here. Do you see them there on your calculator, the three of those, sin, cos, and tan? What are they? They're basically just a ratio or a fraction. So the sine of an angle is the length of the opposite side over the length of the hypotenuse. Okay? The cosine, or the cos, is the length of the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. And the tan of the angle A is the length of the opposite over the adjacent. Okay, I'll give you an example there. So if we had this triangle, the length of this one is 5, 4 and 3. And I'm going to mark an angle here, we'll call it A. Okay. So I'm going to label it first. So the three things I say, draw it, label it, write sohcahtoa. So we've drawn it. Now label it. Where's the longest side, the hypotenuse? Over here. The opposite is across here, OPP, and adjacent is the last one left. What is the sine of A in this case? Well, I can see that A is the opposite over the hypotenuse. So that's O over H. Now, what's the opposite side? Is 4. And the hypotenuse is 5. So it's basically just a fraction like that. That's all it is. The next one, the cos of A is, it's the adjacent over the hypotenuse. So where's my adjacent? Is 3 over the hypotenuse, which is 5. And the tan of A is the last one, which is O over A, the opposite over the adjacent, I'm just shortening it down, is 4 over 3. So they're basically just fractions, okay? Now, how will I remember which is which? So I have a word for it, okay? And it's S. So the sine is the opposite over the hypotenuse, S-O-H. The cos is the adjacent over the hypotenuse. And the tan is the opposite over the adjacent. And that's what I call sohcahtoa. Okay, sohcahtoa. So it will tell you that the sine is the opposite over the hypotenuse, those two. The cos is the adjacent over hypotenuse, and tan is opposite over adjacent. Okay, we'll get very used to using that, right? So the way we're going to do these, draw it, label it, write sohcahtoa. So let's have a look. Find the sine, cos, and tan of the angle shown. And we'll put our angle up here for a change now. Okay, so I'm going to put my angle up here, call it A. Okay, so first thing, so I'm going to just write down here, draw it, label it, and write sohcahtoa. That's the way I'm going to be saying to do these. If I was in class, I'd be getting you to repeat that a load of times. Draw it, label it, write sohcahtoa. Draw it, label it, write sohcahtoa. Okay, so we have it drawn here already. Label it. Okay, so the easiest side to label, and use a different colour for this, is across from your right angle. The longest side is the hypotenuse, HYP. Next up is the opposite. So you go to your angle marked, and it's across from that. So that's the opposite, OPP. And the last one up is the adjacent, ADJ. So I've drawn it, I've labelled it, now write sohcahtoa. So I have SOHCAHTOA. You'll get very, very used to it. You must do that every single time. Draw it, label it, write sohcahtoa. Okay, so the sine of A, you can't just have sine by itself, it has to have an angle with it. Equals O over H equals, so opposite is 1, hypotenuse is 2, and you're done. Okay, so the sine of A is 1/2. Next up, we have the cos of A. Well, that's A over H. So it is root 3 over 2. Done. Next one is the tan. So the tan of A is O over A, which is O opposite is 1. And adjacent is root 3. So it's 1 over root 3. Okay, and leave it like that in third form. Next up, let's have a go at this one. Now, this one, right, I have both angles marked. If you ever have both angles marked, draw it twice. Okay, because it gets confusing otherwise. So I'll draw it out here and here. And this is the one with the angle B, and this is the one with the angle A. So I have 40, 41, 9, 40, 41, and 9. Now, so I draw it, label it, write sohcahtoa. So let's label it. Longest side is the hypotenuse, HYP. Opposite here, OPP. Adjacent here, ADJ. Now, be careful over here, right? So this is my hypotenuse, always stays the same. The angle now is marked here, so across from that is the opposite. And then I have my adjacent down here. So that's why you draw it out twice. So I want the cos of A. So draw it, label it, write sohcahtoa. SOHCAHTOA. You get very used to writing that out, okay, lads? So first thing I'm looking for is the cos of A. So the cos of A equals A over H, which is 9. Over 41, done. And the cos of B, so that's this triangle. So the cos of B is A over H, which is adjacent is 40 over 41. Do you see the difference? Because it's a different angle, the value of the cos is different. And sine A is, so sine is O over H, which is opposite is 40, and I have over 41. And the sine of B, which is O over H, equals 9 over 41.
Okay, next up, two more examples for you, okay? So next up, given the cos of theta, so that's just a Greek letter, okay? Theta or theta, I call it theta. Given the cos of theta is equal to 4 over 5, find the value of tan theta and sine theta, okay? That's just another letter like saying A or B. What are my three steps when I'm solving these? Draw it, label it,
right sohcahtoa.
Okay, so draw it, label it right sohcahtoa. Now you're saying, how can I draw my triangle? I've no idea what it looks like. If you're talking about sine, cos and tan, it has to be a right angle triangle. So you draw a right angle triangle, okay? Now, the cos, okay, so draw it. Now I must label it. So I'm actually going to write sohcahtoa first. S-O-H-C-A-H-T-O-A. I'm looking at the cos here. So what am I interested in? I'm actually going to be interested in the cos is the adjacent over hypotenuse. So what is this? This is the adjacent. This is the hypotenuse. Okay? So I know my hypotenuse is 5. Where is the hypotenuse? It's the longest side here. Okay? Mark your angle theta down here. Now, so this is the hypotenuse, HYP. Opposite is over here, OPP, and down here, ADG. Now, so I have the A and the H, which is 5, and this one is 4. Now, I'm missing a side over here. So if you have two sides looking for a third, how do I get the missing one from last week, Pythagoras' theorem? So I have C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared. So I have 5 squared. Remember, this one always goes by itself. 5 squared equals 4 squared plus x squared. 25 is equal to 16 plus x squared. So you have 25 minus 16 is equal to x squared. 9 is equal to x squared. X is equal to the square root of 9. X is equal to 3. Okay, and fill in your missing side here, which is 3. Okay, now go back to the question. What is the tan of theta? So you know the tan of theta equals O over A. So I have O is 3 and A is 4. Done. Sine of theta. So I have sine of theta equals, looking here, O over H equals 3 over 5 and you're done. Okay, so if you're missing a side, use Pythagoras' theorem. Similarly here, so if the tan of B is equal to 1 over root 3, find the cos of B. Remember, 3 steps. Draw it, label it, and then write S-O-H-C-A-H-T-O-A. 3 steps. Draw it, label it. Draw it, label it, write sohcahtoa. Okay? Now, what type of triangle will it be if we're talking about sine, cos and tan? It's going to be a right angle triangle. Where will my angle be? I'm going to put it down here. You can put it up the top if you like. It doesn't matter. So I know, so I have S-O-H-C-A-H-T-O-A. So I'm looking at tan. Tan is O over A. So this is O and this is A. So the opposite side to this is 1 and the adjacent side is root 3. So I'm missing this side up here. How do I find it? Pythagoras' theorem. C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared. The missing one goes by itself. X squared is equal to root 3 squared plus 1 squared. X squared equals, now put that into your calculator, you get 3 plus 1. So X squared is equal to 4. So X is equal to square root of 4. X is equal to 2. Fill it into the diagram. So this is my opposite. This is my hypotenuse. And this is the adjacent. And what am I asked for? I'm looking for the cos of the angle. So I know that cos of angle is A over H. So I go here. What's the adjacent? Root 3 over 2. Okay, I'm going to put up pictures of those lads and I'll give you some questions from the book. Actually, I have it here. So we're going to go for page 502. Question number 1 to 5. So we'll go 1 to 5 and then we'll go 6 to 12 for the next day. So I'll give you 2 days work there together. So this is for Tuesday and this is for Wednesday. I'll put that up all on Google Classroom, okay? Most important things, draw it, label it, write sohcahtoa. Okay, thanks lads.